All right, time to get into WWF Shotgun Saturday Night, January 11th, 1997. Of course, the World Wrestling Federation for over 50 years, the Revolutionary Force of Sports Entertainment.
Of course, but before we get to that, James, we have to talk about what was going around in the world of wrestling at the time, and there actually wasn't. 97 wasn't hot at the time
in
wrestling at all.
Not hot. Shit, you weren't watching the competition, brother.
Bro,
brother.
Nobody was watching wrestling in 1997. What was going on? The NWO?
It was the peak of WCW.
The American Males.
Yes. See, you remember now. And what do you call that, buddy?
Yes, of course I remember the group.
Yeah, there you go.
And there was two people in it.
You Mandela'd.
So anyway, the January 6, 1997 Observer and WCW news here. From all accounts, I've never heard of this before, so I don't know. I just thought this. I needed to bring
the Frame Meister.
No, the Frame Meister is not here.
Dude.
From all accounts, Tony, the Frame Meister is not going to work, bro.
It's
just not going to happen.
Shut up. Just go on with accounts, tell me. Tell me what's happening.
From all accounts, Tony, the deal to bring in Bam Bam Bigelow to WCW fell through as Bigelow turned it down. They wanted him in the NWO, and one of the main reasons he left the WWF in the first place was because he was mad about the amount of power Kevin Nash and the company had. Tatanka is a question mark. So I don't know if that means Tatanka is also being considered for the NWO, but I don't remember any. I don't remember hearing Bam Bam being an NWO guy.
Why wouldn't he? That, everybody else is in it.
Well, fuck Kevin Nash, that's what you said.
Yeah, just everybody else. I'm pretty sure no one in the NWO like Kevin Nash either, so it doesn't matter.
Bam Bam doesn't come in for like a couple more years, right? Does he come in 98 or 99 WCW?
I don't remember.
I want to say 99, but maybe it was 98. Yeah, maybe it was late 98, okay. After ECW didn't pay him, shockingly.
Wow.
WWF news from the weekend Superstar Show. It appears that Vic Venom did get heat about saying Bret Hart would win the Rumble so assuredly the previous week, since Bret is scheduled to win.
How you fucking say that shit? Knows. It's weird how he knows.
Yeah, how do you know that shit? He came back and kind of backed off, saying you never know for sure who could win the Rumble. JR also called Barry Windham Stalker gimmick another lame marketing idea and mention how Farouk's original headgear gimmick will go into the WWF Marketing Hall of Fame with a gobbledygooker. So JR is a very angry
JR
man
has a
still.
Lot to say.
In 1997.
I think JR's always been angry. I think it is.
That's why, I mean, listen, man, JR's seen this a lot and he's had enough back then and now.
He's had enough in 97.
Yeah. Fucking hell. From the Observer, January 13th, 1997, the debut of Shotgun Saturday Night, which we also have reviewed on this podcast.
Is that the one with Masquerita Sagrada?
Yes, it is. Oh. It is what I refer to as the most underrated episode of Deadlock ever, because I don't think anybody listens to it.
Oh, yeah. Bummer about that.
It's a legendary show. If you have not listened to it, you are missing out. You need to go and fucking listen to that and then listen to this one, because this is the follow-up to it. Debut of Shotgun Saturday Night on January 4th was largely a flop, content and reaction-wise. The show didn't air in this market, but the reaction was 100% negative by those who called and faxed, and strongly negative for that matter. I can't imagine going out of my way to fax into something and say this shit fucking sucks. You had to have really fucking hated something to fucking go out of your way for that shit.
Hating was crazy back then.
Oh, you had to like
I dialed your
effort.
Ass. Your mind.
Effort. Yeah, I fucking put a paper into this fucking thing, dialed it, and waited for it to send to your bitch ass because I wanted you to know how much I didn't like
your shit.
You
couldn't even get numbers off that. Like, you couldn't even get numbers. The only person that saw the hate was you and the person you were sending it to.
Yeah, there was no, you weren't trying to gain anything from it. Yeah, you're right. Now it's completely changed. Now, yeah,
now you do it for the numbers. Back then, back in my day, we used to
hating
fax. So we were clicking numbers and sending hate. That's
hell
all we did.
Yeah.
Like, yeah. If you can believe it, we breeded hate. Hate breed. All right, so we start with the cold open here. Honky Tonk Man is... he's harassing
the revolutionary force in sports entertainment. You gotta get that in there.
I did. I said that when we first started.
Say it again.
No
say
way.
It again.
Sports entertainment.
The revolutionary force for over 400 years.
I like the Matt Menard version. The revolutionary force in sports and entertainment.
For over 50 years, it's in the last couple of years, we get our ass stomped.
Yeah, well, we're forcing you to watch this shit, bitch.
Honky Tonk Man is harassing people in a hotel lobby.
What is wrong? Is it a hotel lobby or is it a haircut place?
This is where you get your haircut and your shoe shined all in the same
haircut place.
But it is also a hotel.
Yeah, well, there's a guy getting his shoe shine. He doesn't want to fucking talk to the honky tonk man.
And, he's reading a newspaper.
He
Leave
is
me alone.
Harassing the fuck out of him.
Yeah, he says, when the honky tonk man is in New York City, I hang out with the stars at the St. Regis Hotel. The best haircuts in the world. What?
Get the fuck out of here, man.
You get your shoes shined, but when you wear blue suede shoes like me, you don't have to worry. He looks at the guy shining the other guy's shoes and he says, that's some ugly ass shoes you have on.
Now, hold on a minute.
Hey, yo. What are those? Yo,
fuck this motherfucker. We should have jumped the honky tonk man. That's what I should have done.
I thought they were going to have the guy like pull down a newspaper and it would be like, you know, a wrestler and then have a match. No, it was just some dude getting his shoes
shined.
That's
the roadie, bro.
I don't think dude, so, man. There were some major differences between this guy and the roadie, I have to say.
Vince thought the honky tonk man was the greatest gimmick of all time. Like, he was really rocking. He said, this is the guy right here.
Dude,
the
this adult-man. Is 1997.
Honky Tonk Adultman.
Honky Tonk Man hasn't been IC champion for 10 years here. Fucking, he is doing nothing here. And the show is centered around the fucking Honky Tonk Man doing a damn live performance. Get out of our company!
Did you ever hear the story about Eric Bischoff and how he loved firing the Honky Tonk Man?
Oh my God, no, but I want
to
hear it.
He says it comes back to the only guy I ever really enjoyed firing. I mean, it put a smile on my face. In this moment when you ask me that question, I'm getting goosebumps. I'm getting a smile from ear to ear because I had to fire the Honky Tonk Man. I would fire the Honky Tonk Man every single day of every single year for the rest of my life, and I would get just as much joy.
Holy fuck, man, that's a hater.
That's a hater. I know he didn't even FedEx that. He didn't even FedEx that hand delivery.
He showed up at his door.
He knocked on his door. Subpoena style. Big ass smile on his face.
Fuck you, honky tonk man. You. You're a bitch.
Stupid blue suede shoes, dumbass.
Yeah, shove them up your ass, you freak.
So Mark Mara is also here in a limo.
Ah!
Why is Vince is going crazy
Sable. Mark Mara, right here on Shotgun Saturday.
So is this live for shoot or what?
No.
Okay, so why the fuck, you know, we'll talk about later, but holy schmoly, man. Unbelievable.
Unless it is, but I don't think it is.
I wouldn't be surprised, but I don't know.
It's probably live to tape, you know? That's what I think, probably.
That's what every show.
No.
Every show is live to tape.
Never.
God damn.
Well, the memo is sent out fax style for this show. So how many times can we cut and zoom and blur all the footage so no one can see what's going on?
I do like the intro to the show, though. Very, I feel like it was very appropriate for the show. Just a lot of zooming in.
None of the dudes in the intro were on the show. It's just Savio Vega and Honky Tonk Man. Shawn Michaels is out of the show.
What are you talking about, bro? Goldust drinking at the bar and then Undertaker coming up from a sewer.
Undertaker
as the
and HBK are not here.
And Bob Backlund's talking to the cab drivers. You know, this is crazy.
Come on, man.
We didn't even follow up on any of that. Where is Mascarilla Sagrada? He was with the ladies.
You know where he is. He's with the ladies.
He didn't bring him back to the bar or nothing?
No. Well, you
he
know,
said, I am not bringing the hose around the Honky Tonk Man.
No way,
it's
man.
Not happening.
He's a weird fucker.
You
he's
are scaring the hose, Honky Tonk Man. Get out of here.
The hose. Yeah, man.
So we have Mark Mara versus
Diesel.
Who is this man?
The hold big on, monster hold Diesel.
Oh, they run down this card. It's Wild yes. Man versus Diesel. Savio Vega versus Farouk. Rocky Maivia versus Razor Ramon. I was like, man, this is kind of cool, actually.
And then I go,
oh, wait, this is 97. They were in WCW.
Dude, it took me even longer than that to realize it, Tony. Because so they run down
no,
the card.
No, I'll tell they you. Show
they show live at the All-Star Cafe. So they advertise this big Wild Man versus Big Monster Diesel. Big Monster Diesel. So they open the show. Sonny's dancing on the announce table. Vince intros, oh, this is the sexy Sonny. Sonny says, oh, wait till you see my sexy home video. Now, if you recall, the first episode of Shotgun Saturday Night was building to this episode of Shotgun Saturday Night where Sonny was going to get fucked live on TV.
We tell stories here, pal.
So Sonny says, oh, see my home video. And Vince says, ah, well, what do you got to say about that, Todd? Fucking Todd Pettengill is the star of these shows. He is putting his whole dick and balls into these.
He deserves like a million, billion trillion dollars of all this.
Todd Pengel says somebody's gonna get lucky tonight, and also the Sisters of Love were arrested for solicitation.
in front of the Disney store.
What the fuck? And then they show it. They show the Sisters of Love, which, if you recall, were the Sisters of... What were they fucking...
They're the Flying Nuns.
The Flying Nuns, yes. They were the Flying Nuns, and they joined... Brother Love.
Mother Schmucker.
Mother
Schmucker. Nobody told Vince, by the way, because he still called him the Flying Nuns. And the Flying Nuns were arrested. So he said, that's the Sisters of Love. All right, anyways.
Ah, whatever. Fuck you. Who are you. We got to fuck him or not?
Don Fagel says, the Sisters of Love were arrested for solicitation in front of the Disney store by undercover cops. It cuts back and Vince McMahon goes, bummer. Then Mark Mara makes his entrance and Vince goes, ah, yeah! What so, the fuck
at this point,
happening?
I am still thrilled. I am excited.
You get to see Sunny and you get to see Sable.
Wildman Mark Mara is making his entrance and here comes Mark Mara and Sable, which they're lost. They get lost in the crowd. Here.
Some fan like grabs them or something and then... I think yeah. Sonny's like, people get touchy feely when you're this sexy or something. Like
that. Oh, yeah. Yeah.
You're right.
So, it's not even showing Sable yet. It's just no. Mark Mara.
That's not an exaggeration, but that is.
No.
That's 100% legit.
Wild man.
He legit says,
Come on out of here. So Mark Mara and Sable struggle to get through this crowd. They get lost and can't get to the ring.
Yeah, nobody paid to get in here. They're all drunk at a sports bar. Come on,
they don't give a fuck.
No.
It's a whoa. Wow, man. Ah. And then I'm staring at the screen, and I see Diesel in the ring, and I said, well, that's fucking weird. Diesel got a jobber entrance? And then it hit me. I said, oh, it's 1997. Holy fuck.
Dude.
It's Kane.
It did not hit me until Diesel did a flying clothesline. I said
the same way because I was sitting there and there were so many pixels on the screen.
Tony, me too. It was the pixels. I was like half-ass paying attention and like
I was writing notes down, writing stuff.
Yeah,
and
I was like, Diesel, that's pretty sweet. Diesel got Diesel in here, Rocket.
Oh my god, there it is, the sideline.
Dude, that's fucking unbelievable.
There were so many pixels, I thought it was a real Diesel.
That's true, it is hard to tell.
We were watching mean fucking YouTube version of this.
Well, this isn't on Peacock or anything like that. This is the only version that exists.
Yeah. Vince
says, this is a wonderful location. And Sonny says, Diesel's looking mighty fine tonight. And Vince says, well, are you fucking him in the tape or what are you doing there? This is
sex?
All night. Vince is just asking Sonny who she's fucking in this tape. It's like, what about Diesel? He's very cute. Yeah, you fuck him.
Vince has seen the video.
Vince produced the video.
Sonny's seen the video. They know what's in the video. And yet they still, you fucking him tonight. What?
This is also, is this an 18 or a 16 ring?
I think it's 18.
It looked like 18. The first
it's
one
not
was,
a 20 for sure.
It's not 20. They would always run the smaller rings. Well, I think
The
last one might have been a 16, wasn't it?
Yeah,
I think
the first
small.
One was a 16.
Okay, and this is an 18. Okay. Yellow ropes here once again for Shotgun Saturday Night. These guys are.
Don't let
fucking...
it be passed by the way. Sable is a complete smoke show here.
Oh my god, she's unbelievable.
Yeah,
Sonny looks incredible at this time too, man. Yeah. I mean, they both are on fucking real here. Diesel, who I will refer to as only Diesel because that's who they want you to believe it is. Diesel goes outside. He's flirting with Sable on the floor. Everyone, this is 15 minutes of people coming in and out and trying to fuck Sable.
Yeah, you heard him right. It is a 15-minute fucking match.
It's fucking unbelievably long. So Diesel goes outside to flirt with Sable. Sable hits Diesel in the face with cake, and then the fans start chanting ECW.
ECW.
They do chant ECW.
They have had enough. They came here, they didn't pay shit, and they're going to get everything over but this show. Mid-match now, Vince throws to Todd Pettengill, who is now interviewing Sable at ringside during the match.
Yeah, he does.
Well, we got 15 minutes here tonight, so we're going to take a couple of breaks in between this one.
Todd Pettengill asks about Diesel, and Sable says, I didn't like what Diesel was doing, and personally, I think he takes the cake. And Vince says, ha ha!
Todd Pettengill asks Sable about Diesel as Diesel is fighting in the ring right now. I don't know, just look at the fucking ring.
What do you think of this guy?
They went picture for this, by the way, so there's a little caution tape or whatever, yellow tape, and then the little thing in the corner, and then the match going on inside.
Sonny says that Mark Mara and Sable had to take a limo because Sable would have gotten too many $10 offerings dressed like that.
She also asked if Sable would be upset if she saw her honey bunny in her home sex video. I am fucking the wild man.
Brother, you know you had sex with the doll.
Ah, but what about the wild man?
Vince also ponders that the flying nuns will get 3 years like Heidi Fleiser.
What the fuck,
Vince,
man?
They are the sisters of love, and you know that.
You booked it.
You named them that. You fucking put them there. Come on, brother.
So Diesel goozles Mark Merrill on the ground. I'm wondering at this point why he's not doing Diesel moves. He's throwing clotheslines. He bumps Mark Merrill around. Then he bumps Mark Merrill to the floor. Then fucking Razor Ramon jumps Mark Merrill on the floor.
Not Scott Hall, by the way.
Oh, sorry. It's Rick Bogner.
Oh, there he is.
Rick Bogner. All the stars are here. Rick Bogner comes here. He starts stomping him out. Then Rocky Maivia comes in from outside the building, cutscene style, to make the fucking save. He jumps fake Razor, trips over the stairs, and lands fucking ass first on a Mark Mero's head.
That's a Rock and Jabroni, dude. Rock and Jabroni, dude.
Get this little dude out of here.
Get this little Jabroni out of here. Shotgun, sorry, now you're out of here, dude. Not on our show. Not on me and fake Diesel and fake Razor show, dude.
Fake Hogan.
Fake Hogan, that's me, Boulder. So Rocky fucking comes and makes a save, and then Pat Patterson yells at The Rock as we go to commercial.
The Rock's the cheesiest fucking... He is the cheesiest cheese.
He's baby-faced out as ever you could imagine.
This is like... This can't work. This will never work in wrestling.
They already are turning on him.
They had Rocky Maivia make saves for every single person on the show.
You're right.
He was fucking saving all the women.
He was
women.
The hero.
He was the Mary fucking Sue. Main event fucking, you know what I mean? Beating the shit out of Razor type shit. This never had a chance. Especially in 97. I don't know what they were thinking. They got a show called Shotgun Saturday Night where it's HBK, you know, dancing in the streets and Undertaker coming out as a gimmick as he had done yet.
Goldust is drinking and they got Masquerade Sagrada dancing.
You got Rocky Maivia coming out saving.
Clean.
No way.
Yeah.
Not happening.
Well, don't worry. They fix it. Eventually.
Anyways, we're in an underground WWF bunker because we have to... We have to learn that WWF is returning to Madison Square Garden at 1 p.m. in the afternoon.
They stuck Doc Hendricks in hell to advertise this.
It's on the bombs are coming.
Sean doesn't like Brett. Brett doesn't like Sean. And Psycho Sid doesn't like either of them. Wow. Also on this card, Ahmed Johnson and Salvia Vega against Crush and Farouk.
All right. Anyways, 1 p.m. come out or don't.
1 p.m. is crazy.
Undertaker Sid for the WWF title. Sean and Mankind with Paul Bearer. Brett and Vader. Stone Cold and Goldust.
Not a single one had a finish.
No.
Oh, 1 p.m. 1 p.m. show. No. Oh, no. Contest. No, DQ. Take it home. I bet you that Bret Hart and Vader match didn't even happen.
Anyway, we come back from commercial. This match is still fucking going on here. There's also a guy in the front row who stands on his chair in front of the crowd blocking people's view for the entire show.
They didn't pay anything. That shit.
Right. Yeah, you're right. I guess he didn't pay for the seat. Anyway, Todd Pettengill's interviewing the Honky Tonk Man.
The Honky Tonk Man promises that he will have sex with Sable.
Yeah, he says, we're going to do a duet. Todd says, we're going to do a duet. And Sable looks pretty good, huh? And Honky Tonk Man says, I can't believe that's Sable. What?
Yeah, you heard him.
And Honky Tonk has a tune especially for her. Love Me Tender. And Todd Pettengill says, whoa, back to you guys.
Anyways, Diesel with the flying clothesline.
He goes up top and does the cane line.
Diesel starts climbing to the top rope, and I say, there's no way.
That's right.
There's no way this
He's
is happening.
Popping off.
Vince says, new move here. I said, no.
Yeah.
Diesel leaps off the top and invents the cane clothesline. I could not fucking believe my eyes, dude. Cane clothesline from Fake Diesel. Oh my god, that's the fucking best shit ever. We saw the origin of
the cane line, I think.
I think, yeah, because Vince says it's a new move. I think it was the first time he did it.
Wow, history. That's classic Diesel. Either that or it's Mandela Effect, you know, I can't tell.
I guess
maybe. Once again, right, Diesel works harder, baby. Nobody's beating Kevin Nash here. He didn't even do the fucking move, and he still did the fucking move. No one's working smarter than Kevin Nash.
He's on even two Diesel, shows at once. What the hell?
Fake Diesel can't even lose. That's unbelievable.
Diesel's
that's
on power, two y'all. Shows, and he's fucking over on both of them. Like, yo, no one's working like Kevin Nash.
So Mark Mero hits the ropes. Diesel hits him with the most fucked up boss man slam, black hole slam fuck ever. I don't know.
You're going for head scissor, but Mark Mero says skew.
Right.
Sorry about that.
I didn't know. I was like, what the fuck was that? Then they run it back. They go for the spot again. Diesel goes for a side slam. Mark Mero turns into a head scissors, and Diesel somehow flip bumps behind Mark Mero and gives himself a pile driver.
Fuck. By the way, Mark Mero, for 10 minutes of this match, got no hope at all.
Just heat.
Diesel was beating the fuck out of him. He didn't even fight back once. I bet he was like, damn, that's pretty funny. He's just beating the shit out of this dude.
It's probably because Kevin Nash sent him a fax. You better make me look good.
All he said on the fax was no hope. He said, damn. He knew what was going on.
So Mark Mero, Honky Tonk Man, is back. And he's outside trying to hit on Sable.
Never left, man. This guy sucks.
All Honky while, Tonk Man, dude, he's sucks. A bitch. I hate the Honky Tonk Man.
This is real heat, brother. This is real heat.
Him. I can't Honky wait Tonk to fire man. Him. Fire him right now.
I'm going to fire him. Yeah, I'm calling an audible, Tony. Actually,
this is crazy, man.
So Honky Tonk is hitting on Sable on the outside. All the while, Mark Mero is on the top rope. He's jumps up into the air, turns around, lands back on the top rope, jumps off the top rope backwards, moonsault all the way across the ring, and it is the craziest looking thing in the world I've ever seen.
Assault. That's the Mero assault, brother.
It was the coolest thing in the world, and I can't. And then he fucking hits that, doesn't go for a pin, and runs outside to confront the Honky Tonk Man. God damn it!
Hey, what are you
trying
to say before? What are you doing? What are you doing, Sable, over there?
Oh,
dude, this Mark Mero Sable thing goes on for like 2 years after this, too.
Yeah, you're right. He changes gimmicks completely and it's still rocking.
It's still, that's all he's got is fucking Sable.
I don't blame him. That's real shit. I hear you on that.
So Mark Mero goes outside to confront the Honky Tonk Man. Diesel no sells this sweet ass double jump moonsault because Kevin Nash told him to.
Learn to work.
Does a double X handle off the apron and barely touches Mark Mero and throws him back in the ring. Honky Tonk Man just leaves. Fake Diesel hits jackknife powerbomb and beats Mark Mero.
Bro,
I bet you the same exact shit happened on WCW.
You're right. I gotta look.
Diesel hit the jackknife.
Bro, if I'm getting beat by a fake version of a wrestler that used to be in the company, I'm packing my bags and I'm getting out of here, man. My career
Dude,
is over.
Well, it's because of Tony, the Honky Tonk Man.
Tony, not only was it getting beat by him, he took 10 minutes of heat, got a double jump moonsault, and then got hit with a finisher and fucking lost.
Fake Diesel finisher.
It's fucking believable.
Holy fuck.
Sable gets in the ring to check on Mero after the match. Mark Mero is angry. He cannot believe that he lost to the Fake Diesel.
You got your ass kicked for like 15 minutes, pal.
All the while, Sonny is also running down Sable on commentary, saying that it is Sable's fault and that Mark Mero should be fucking her, and she laughs very loud at her. Anyway, here comes the Honky Tonk Man, and he's dancing in the ring.
The Honky Tonk Man gets
get
in the ring.
Out of our company!
And does his fucking taunt.
He does the Honky Tonk taunt
Nothing would have made me more happy. And Fake Diesel whooped his fucking ass.
Dude,
why did Sable's he do the taunt?
Sable's on her knees weeping. Honky Tonk Man is like, hey, just do this fucking shit.
If you played with the Honky Tonk Man in the games and you did that taunt to me, I would quit. I'd disconnect. My internet went out. Yeah, I'm telling the police or something, but you're done. My dad works for Microsoft and you're done.
Like, Honky Tonk, was he trying to seduce Sable here with his dance moves?
No, he's a big dumbass. He's an idiot.
Well, Speaking of big dumbasses.
Get out of our company. Fucking give me more time with Diesel.
Speaking of more big dumbasses, here comes Rocky Maivia to make the save.
What are you doing? This fucking goody two-shoes.
White EC meat baby dub. Face EC coming
Die, Rocky, die. So Rocky comes out. Honky Tonk Man powders. Rocky checks on Sable. Then Mark Mero comes back to the ring to confront Rocky Maivia.
What did the Honky Tonk... What did Rocky even make this save for? Honky Tonk Man got the ring. He got the ring.
Wasn't even doing nothing.
He's got to help Sable, man. He's got to help Sable.
Sable, get away from this fucking piece of shit.
But then on top of that, why was Mark Merrill upset that Rocky helped her?
Because it shotgun shattered it.
He's a jealous boyfriend, of course. So they start shoving each other, and then they start brawling, and the referees come out to break them apart, this big hot angle, and then Mark Merrill makes Sable leave with them. Yeah.
This is so they leave together. Unbelievable.
Yes.
Wow.
So people are still watching this at this point, I think.
No fucking way. They show us the Sisters of Love mugshots or the Flying Nuns, whatever Vince wants to say.
The Sisters of Love, goddammit.
Yeah, whatever. I don't understand what I'm supposed to be looking at here. That's it. All right.
Vince says they will not be here. He lets you know.
Laugh at this.
They're not going to be here.
But then he does say, we'll have tag team action with the Headbangers later. I was like, huh?
Yeah, so that's the angle is that they are completely different people.
The angle is that they are completely pathetic.
They do not care.
And so are you, the Honky Tonk Man. Get the fuck out of our company.
Fucking hell.
Savio Vega versus Farouk is up next.
Don't worry about that. Here comes JC Ice and Wolfie D doing a live performance of the Nation theme, baby.
Of domination.
Hell yeah.
PG-13 style.
They're rocking here. The Nation of Domination come out with Farouk. They're all in suits. Farouk is looking gigantic. And as they're making their entrance, Vince says, and also tonight, Sonny's sexy home video.
Dude, fuck this match. The sexy home video is coming up soon, boys.
Don't worry about Farouk. How about Sonny getting her shit blown out? Yeah.
Dude, before the match starts, we get the WWF tour. And it shows the schedule, and it's like a week from today, 2 weeks from the day, next week after the day. It's just the shows are like January 24th, 25th, 26th, 27th. Why do you just say for the whole week we are here going here?
Every day.
A week from the day, rocking. A day from the week. What the fuck? Schedule back then was crazy, and they were working on that concrete ring.
Shit-ass ring, dude. Yeah.
Man, that's nuts.
Fucking hell.
Anyways, we come back from commercial. We're in a chin lock. EC dub
chants in the chin lock, and Farouk is using the bottom rope for leverage. I am over this shit already. Fucking hell. Also, do you have any recollection of Sonny managing the Nation of Domination? Because that's what they talk about here. I fucking don't remember that at all.
No, that must have been real early on, right?
Yeah, like.
I guess Sonny managed Farouk. Is that how that worked? I don't know.
I'm not a real big 95. WWF guy, I assume that's when that happened.
Was it Farouk? Okay, maybe it was just Farouk.
Oh, she was managing Farouk in the debut, in Farouk's debut in the blue.
When was that? What year?
When he was with the what a fucking shitty ass fucking headgear
with that thing. I don't know when that was.
That shit ass.
I don't know when that was. Yeah, I hear you on that. Anyways,
it was 95. I think it was.
Oh here. Wow, I knew it. Yeah, I wasn't a big 95 WWF guy.
I see that.
Todd Pettingill's with my boy William from Westchester.
Yeah.
Dude. He said, who do you think's gonna have sex with Sonny tonight? William said, it should have been me.
He said, so they fought. Hold on, just before we get to that, by the way, Sonny says, oh, I'm glad Clarence Mason is here. He is a strong proponent of Ebonics. How about you, Vince? And Vince says, I don't think I agree with that.
Yeah.
Vince is getting all political out here. I don't agree with that.
What the fuck are you talking about, dude? And this is where Vince says, you might want to get your VCRs out because the conclusion of this matchup, Sonny's home sex video. Let's go to Todd Pettengill. And Todd says, I got my VCR Plus all program, Vince. VCR Plus.
VCR Plus. You can put a timer on the thing. You remember that thing?
Oh, this man, VCR get Plus? That, man. That technology is crazy.
He's got that Vince McMahon WWF money. Todd Pettengill with VCR Plus.
Yeah, he's getting paid. So Todd says, hey, buddy, what's your name? And the guy says, William.
My name's William.
Todd says, who do you think is going to be making love with Sunny Night? And William says, well, look at her. I think it'll be the $6 million man.
Steve Austin? What? Whoa. That's awesome.
I don't know what. I mean, I knew that, but like, what? And then he says, but I wish it was me. And Todd goes, yeah.
Dude, William rips his fucking head off. It should have been me.
That's awesome, man.
Well, Vince says, well, we're going to have to wait and see. It's Farouk, isn't it? You gotta fuck Farouk.
As Beast?
He does say that, and then he goes, no, we're just friends. We're just friends.
No, we're just friends. All right, Drew. So, fucking, these guys are having the shittiest match ever here.
So here we go. Savio Vega with the vertical suplex. NWO. 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 Dude,
a guy in the front row pops his shirt up. He's wearing a Shotgun Saturday Night shirt. He pops it up, and it has an NWO shirt underneath, and an NWO chant breaks out. I'm assuming they made him wear that shirt.
Yeah,
but
they used to do that all the time back in the day. Put on the WF shirt. You can't wear the WCW shirt.
They do that to me, bro.
They did it to Jams every time he went to TNA and WWE.
I remember that. That's awesome.
Dude, him popping the top, he got a huge pop from the crowd. It was bigger than any pop in the match.
So all I've learned from Shotgun Saturday Night is ECW and WCW were whooping this company.
They were
ass.
Awesome. Yeah, they were way better. That's what the faxes were saying as well.
We are whooping your ass, Paulie.
Dude, speaking of whooping ass, Savio gets pissed at one point and starts lighting Farouk up with chops, just fucking annihilating him.
Sounded loud as hell, too.
Yeah, it was awesome. Savio turns around in the corner at one point and smacks the dog shit out of Farouk. I don't know if it was in his face or what, but it looked like he fucked him up with a big style. And then Savio misses a stinger splash in the corner, and Farouk hits him with the Main Event Spinebuster for the win.
At one point, they do an electric chair drop, which is kind of cool. They get him up for one.
Oh, yeah, they did do that. Savio, I think, did that to Farouk.
On that concrete ring you're talking about. That sounded nasty when he did that.
Yeah, whatever. NWO.
You think like Paulie paid like his street team to go to these shows and just chant EC Dub?
It's probably even better. ECW fan just wanted to go do that.
Yeah, that's awesome. You're They're right. riding for that company. It cuts over to Vince and Sonny, and Sonny is over here dancing as Vince is talking about the home sex video.
Yeah, pick up the phone and call somebody because it's time for the Sonny home sex video.
I love
if you called me and told me this shit, I would have said, thank you, brother. I appreciate that. I'm going to tune in right now.
I would have told you to go to hell. I ain't turning on Shotgun Saturday, and I'm watching WWE Worldwide or something.
Yeah, yeah, I got snacks. Iron Mike today. That's that boy, huh?
Iron Mike today is crazy.
Iron Mike today. Scotty Hudson.
Awesome name.
You're rocking here on Saturday night. Yeah, we're here. I have no idea what I was talking about. Iron Mike today. NWO.
Pick up that shotgun shit for Sonny's home sex video. Yeah.
Call me, Tony, and tell me, man.
Hell no.
Why the fuck I care about this, man? I get to see Sonny ECW soon.
You're right. She's crazy in ECW too,
fuck
dude.
This video, stupid shit.
But it's time for the Sonny home sex video.
Sexy video. It's a sexy video.
Sorry. Yes. So we go to a shot of Sonny in a bedroom, or what seems to be a bedroom. It is a room that has a bed in it. And she says, "Good evening."
This is absurd. She does a YouTube intro.
She does YouTube intro, you're right. She says, welcome to my lair of love. She's laying there holding Elmo. It's a little Tickle Me Elmo doll.
You know, because Christmas just happened, right?
Yes, this is January, so Christmas just passed. I have my favorite present of all here, Tickle Me Elmo.
What does that mean?
It's the hottest Christmas present this season, James. So the hottest woman in the WWF had to have one. It's her favorite present because it's hot, just like her, dumbass.
So,
yes.
Okay.
Go on.
So did she recorded this as a request?
No.
So that she just introed her own sex tape? So like, yes, she tunes into her own sex tape?
Well, you know, because Pamela and Dad has sex tape. She's like, this is next level here. She's like going above and beyond for sexy videos.
She's
going
to
show it
to the world. She's got it planned out, you know. She's got a script.
Yeah, this is like a plan. This is not a leaked tape.
Hey, everybody's Sonny here. Today, I'm going to be making love. You guys like this kind of content? Remember to record it on your other VCR.
If we get 1,000 likes, I'll do another one.
If we get 1,000 faxes, I'll fuck Elmer Fudd.
The hottest toy in a Christmas season.
It's the hottest cartoon rocker right now, and I will have Daffy Duck blow my shit out.
Sunny style, I like that. So remember to leave a comment. It really helps me out.
share it with your friend. Call your friends and let them know that I'm getting my fucking shit annihilated here on Shotgun Saturday Night.
Please don't watch ECW. Please, God, don't watch ECW, man. I will fuck whoever it takes. Do not watch WCW.
If we get enough Texas Leghorn, Foghorn will fucking beat my shit in.
I'll leave it on the line for you guys to not watch the Eric Bischoff product. I'm begging you.
Sonny says, who is the special man in my life that makes love to me each and every night? Is he someone tall, dark, and handsome? Maybe muscular. Well, you're about to meet him. And there's a knock at the door. This is like a planned skit, too.
Dude, what is this?
So knock at the door. You can see it in the reflection of the mirrors behind her. Eric, in comes life-sized Elmo. Elmo walks into the room and says, oh, boy!
Hey, yo, what the fuck?
I'm a joke. It's like Elmo was not prepared or something.
Elmo, but
it's Elmo in a thong.
Elmo has underwear on.
Dancing! Fortnite move!
He's thrusting.
Fortnite move!
Gyrating. Oh, yeah! I've been bad, Sonny! Elmo crawls into bed and says, finally, Elmo!
I think he says, fondle me, Elmo.
Is that what he says? Yeah. Oh, you're right, because that's his name.
Sonny goes, what a body, come here. And he goes, fondle me, Elmo.
Sonny says, that's right. It's not tickle me, Elmo.
Who is she talking to?
It's his big, strong, bad, older brother, fondle me, Elmo.
You're all going to hell. Everyone involved in this is going to hell.
What is this?
What?
Fondle me, Elmo is here. It's a big fucking Elmo with underwear on. He's laying on the bed. Sonny removes Elmo's underwear, and Elmo goes, "Whoa!"
What the fuck was that?
I'm sorry. Elmo's on the bed, butt furry naked on the fucking bed. Sonny claps. The lights go out, and then you hear, "Boy, oh, yeah. Fucking Elmo gets a fucking hard on."
Not even 25 seconds later, the lights come back on.
Well,
you hear a bunch of sound effects.
Yeah, Sonny is moaning. Elmo is moaning.
You hear YYZ Elmo saying, by Rush, I think, at one point.
Elmo says, you know you want me, baby, and then goes, ah! And then I guess he cummers all up in her shit, and then the lights come back on.
With what penis? Cummers in her shit, raw dog style.
That is the issue here, James, because the lights come back on after Elmo fucking splattles in her, and then Elmo says, wow, fondle me, Elmo, so sorry I broke your trapeze. Is that what he says?
Yes, trapeze, like a sex swing kind of thing, you know?
They had one of those in there?
Is that what they said? Trapeze. It's
a trapeze. Hold on. Now I need to know what you thought.
He said ovaries. I'm like, damn, Elmo, like,
ovaries?
Holy shit.
Elmo shattered your entire reproductive system. Sorry.
With my big Elmo cock. Not like my little brother's little shitty dick. I have big, strong, fun on my elbow, balls, and cock for you.
Elmo just gets more aggressive as it goes on. Elmo was fine, and then Elmo had sex, and then that was it for Elmo.
He's a beast now.
Elmo almost sound like TK.
Chad Elmo. What'd you say?
Why did you almost sound like TK?
Listen, there's only so much high pitch I can do here.
Dude, Elmo does not have the stamina to be with a woman of this caliber.
Well, she seemed very satisfied, James, and she had
Which
a great
time. Which is absurd. 97
bit.
Women were different. I don't know. Well, this is crazy.
He says, sorry I broke your ovaries.
Which is insane.
Sonny says, don't worry about that. The Energizer Bunny's got nothing on you. And Elmo says, I need a cigarette. So Elmo rolls over on her off the bed to retrieve a cigarette. And that's when he stands up and Sonny says, you're a madman. And Elmo says, I know, that's right. And then Elmo, standing there, looks down at his crotch and says, "Sonny, where's Funnel Me Elmo's pants?" And Sonny says, "I don't know."
Bitch, you didn't come in here with pants. There was no pants on Elmo.
He had underwear on.
Just the thong. That's just not pants. The thong.
And then Elmo says, "Sonny, where's Funnel Me Elmo's?" And then the boing sound goes off, and I wrote question marks, a bunch of them. And then it cuts to, it zooms in on Sonny's face, and she smiles and shrugs. Did, like, Sonny break Elmo's cock off in her pussy?
You lost it. It's gone forever. And then it cuts to the honky-tonk man. You're all going to hell.
No!
You were everyone involved in 97 WWF is going to hell. This is unbelievable. No! If you wrote this, you're done. You're done. Yeah,
whoever put this show together deserves you're to be done today.
You want to know who this put this crazy. Together?
Because I got the
who put this together?
The dirt. Sonny talked about it on her U-Shoot thing back in the day, and she said, according to Sonny, this is the rumor, Todd Pettengill was the one dressed up as Elmo.
Which makes so much more sense.
And it was filmed in Todd's bed in his house, and what? Todd Pettengill's wife was the director.
Holy fucking shit, Sonny, Todd Pettengill, Chad.
And Sonny came up with a thong idea. She said it was funny, and they all had a good time doing it. So.
It was funny. You're right. You should
well,
keep...
you booked your one-way ticket. So, to suffering.
It's unbelievable, man. And this was, please, everyone needs to know that Sonny thing was the tune in next week thing.
The on catalyst the first for episode number two, yeah. Yes.
Yeah, it was the fucking thing that advertised for this episode. That was the peak of this show to them. And they still had matches and a honky tonk man sing along coming up here.
Yeah. So this has got to be the worst. I mean, this is, I mean, they've done a lot of shitty shit,
yeah.
But this has got to be top five, top 10 shittiest WWF moments of all time.
Wait, hold on. This next thing or the thing we just talked about?
No, this next thing.
Okay, I agree. I completely agree.
This has got to be so devoid of any creative thought. May God have mercy on your soul. You've ruined wrestling.
So not tapped into this crowd at all.
They're chanting ECW and NWO.
They have Todd Pettengill and the Honky Tonk Man with microphones, and they're advertising. Vince says, "Stay with us, everybody." Vince is begging you to stay with us for this fucking segment. So we come back from commercial. Everyone surely did not stay here. But we come back from commercial, and they're still together here. And Todd Pettengill says, "The Honky Tonk Man is ready to sing." And he's going crazy here, Todd, doing his best to save this fucking shit.
Todd is...
By the way...
Todd is the best.
Todd has a microphone that you can hear. Honky Tonk Man, the guy that is meant to be what the segment is built around singing. You cannot understand him, and I also don't think he can hear the music.
No, his mic does not work, and I said it's probably for the best because he can't sing either.
I think he's just a bum.
I couldn't even write down what they were singing because I was so annoyed at what I was watching that I was physically angry at this shit. I was like, this sucks so bad. I can't even make fun of how shitty this was put together.
I mean, Todd Pettengill was going for it, man. He was all in on this thing. He was singing his heart out here.
He's good, too. Good for
him,
man.
In context to this show, it's actually the worst thing ever. because of the main event, so we had to have this instead of the main event.
Until you wrap it up here, wow!
Don't say it yet, but yes,
yeah. But
they chant ECW during this part also.
They also do.
But I think what Vince was like, his idea here was like, oh, we could do this live event in this bar, and then people do karaoke in bars, and like that would be kind of the idea there. But it fucking sucked.
They didn't even say Journey.
This is also not live, so like. They didn't have to do this.
Honky Tonk Man said that he would reveal every single Vince McMahon secret that's ever existed if he dared to cut one single part of this segment.
Dude, so they just fucking sing. They sing the shittiest song ever, and Honky Tonk Man is singing, and you can't hear him. He's out of tune, and he fucking sucks.
Even when they throw it to him, and they're like, all right, because you can tell like Todd's got his thing, and then Honky's got the
song. I'm Honky Tonk Man, yeah.
And you can't even hear it.
I'm Honky Tonk Man making them sandwiches. Got the sandwiches.
Holy shit.
Dude. You're done. Dave Meltzer shows up and starts singing with them.
What I wasn't some fan here.
Who the fuck was... Yeah, that's what Vince... some fan is there with him, and he's outperforming the Honky Tonk Man.
Cut the fucking segment, Vince. Come on, man.
Todd is singing more than the Honky Tonk Man. Some dude drinking a beer walks into the shot and gets dragged away and probably beaten.
So real.
And then the Honky Tonk Man just sings, and then the fucking segment is over. It's horrible. It's fucking horrible.
Fuck you. Fucking fuck you, man.
There is fucking no way they were ever going to come back. Like, how is WWF expect to compete with WCW with this shit? What the fuck? There's no
this
way.
Fuck you. This is a rocket.
Eric Bischoff probably this. Eric Bischoff watched this segment here with the hardest cock of all time. He said, I have got y'all fucked up, bro.
You have no idea what you guys are fucking doing here.
This
you
is
are
the
dead
easiest shit I ever... Bro, we got the Macho Man. Fuck you.
You had the Sting with baseball bats coming down, beating up the entire NWO, like the coolest shit ever.
Dude, NWO itself!
It was like peak...
The cruiserweights are rocking!
We're in like peak Sting versus NWO stuff in WCW at the time, and then they have this shit on the competition. There's
Jim Ross said, we got the young shooters out here. Honky Tonk Man said, you hold the fuck up. You wait
yeah,
a minute,
I'm not going buddy. Anywhere. Where am I going? Where am I going?
I know fucking in the context. Hell. I know in the context of you sure. know it's fucking shocking. Say like, whatever, it don't matter. But
no,
fuck you. This is the most ridiculous.
Just
thing
because it's
seen.
On a shitty. Just because it's a shotgun Saturday. This is a show that, in theory, it's their second episode. Surely they didn't want it to suck.
No,
but
yeah.
It sucked balls.
Fuck.
Not even the cog, just the balls.
It's Honky Tonk Man's fault, to be honest.
Well, don't worry. But here comes Rocky Maivia.
You're done.
Rocky Maivia comes out and Honky Tonk Man points at him aggressively as he walks by. And now it's time for Rocky Maivia versus, you guessed it, Razor Ramon.
Not Razor Ramon.
No entrance for Razor Ramon. Why would they disrespect both of these guys here, Tony?
How do you go from the sex tape to that to the fake Razor, the fucking not... Fuck! I hate this
we
show.
We don't care. We don't care. Not even a little bit.
Come on.
We don't care.
We don't care.
Well, come on. Let's talk about this
Rocky Maivia versus
match.
Fake Razor Ramon's up next.
So, Rocky Maivia is throwing drop kicks as if he's trying to throw an enziguri. I'm fucking so confused at what he's doing here. It was startling to me.
He debuted like 6 months ago or something?
Yeah, I think that's right. Probably Survivor Series 96. Is that right? Yeah,
he is the ultimate goody two-shoes, man.
Yeah. They sucks. Just had no idea what they had here, but they figure it out eventually.
Well, I'm sure he figures it out.
Somebody thankfully figures it out. They don't figure it out on Shotgun Saturday.
They honky tonk, man.
No way. Well, they figure out that they should fire the Honky Tonk Man, which is great.
Eric said he's going to do that too.
I don't want to fire. He wants to hire him just to fire him, is what he wanted to do.
That's awesome. I love that. There's Razor Chance followed by We Want Hall Chance.
I did hear that. We Want Hall. I wasn't sure if
it took me forever. It took me forever to hear We Want Hall, but yeah.
And so do I.
Anyway,
so do we.
The Honky Tonk Man is out here again.
Fucking go away, dude. I don't need to see this guy ever again in my life.
Honky Tonk Man is here, baby. We're back. I got long sideburns, my hair slick back. I'm coming
dude,
back.
I just imagine like the you know the chart of the live ratings. Like anytime Honky Tonk stuff, they go up, and then they go. Honky Tonk comes back. All ratings are up again. I get about.
Hell yeah, the savior of fucking Saturday
they
night.
They call
it
Shotgun
draw,
Saturday
brother.
Night because everyone wanted to take a shotgun to their face when they saw Honky Tonk Man. Fuck, go away.
Fuck you, man. Long sideburns. I'm doing the dance. I'm doing the dance. I'm doing the dance.
Blue suede shoes. Get the fuck out of our company.
Yeah, he got Honky Tonk Man doing his little fucking dance. You got La Parker over there going crazy with the knees.
Honky Tonk moves. Do it again.
Yeah. Oh, my God. Rocky sucks. Rocky so sucks.
Yeah, Rocky sucks chance. All the while Vince is saying, wow, oh,
Rocky sucks. We want Hall.
Vince is on commentary ignoring the match and saying he hears that Todd Pettengill is making his way as we speak to Times Square.
Holy.
Why?
Dude, they would chant Rocky sucks and his fucking hope. He's like fighting back, trying to bring it back. Rocky sucks. All right.
The fucking lights in the building go out. The fucking light guy is falling asleep during this shit, too.
To watch the Honky Tonk Man for 3 hours, man.
Todd Pettengill just straight up left the building and they admitted it. Like,
he left.
He's out of here.
Honky Tonk Man won't leave him alone. He's fucking pissed. Everybody's mad.
Well, Razor goes for the Razor's edge, but Rock back body drops him, and then Rocky Maivia picks up Razor and hits him with his finishing move at the time, the shoulder breaker.
Holy shit, is that like the worst finish of all time? That sucks.
Well, he wins with it,
there's
Bozo.
There's no way he's getting over with that move. No way.
You're going to hell with Honky Tonk Man.
Not only does he win the match, but fake Razor kicks out at 3.1. Fuck you, Rocky Maivia. I hate your guts.
He kicks out at 3.1, and Rock wins, and the crowd boos him. Rocky Maivia is less over than fake Razor.
Then they cut to Tonk Pedgill. Then they just cut straight to Tonk Pedgill, don't they? I swear.
Yeah, they don't give a fuck. Rock doesn't even get to celebrate. They're already at Tonk Pedgill in Times Square.
Fake
fuck this
Razor
fucking guy.
LOL, Hall and Nash win again. One more for the good guys.
Holy shit.
Fucking Rick Bogner's not taking that shit, dude.
That
fuck out of here.
That wasn't even 3.1. That was like 3 and as fast as you could kick out.
Yeah, it was. The ref knew they had to take it home. It was just over.
Dude, that's unreal. Ooh. They're like, how did this even fly? This is insane, man.
What do you mean?
This is the real Razor Ramon. You said Rocky beat him on the Saturday Night Tape Show
with
the
shoulder breaker. Yeah. Well, it's a fucking problem.
Look, man, I'm not saying that Vince couldn't book shit out of an ass, but this is crazy.
It's even funnier when you think about early in the show. Fake Diesel went 15 with Mark Mero and won. That's even. Mark Mero's like a regular.
Mark Mero was in storylines.
Yeah, Mark Mero's like over his shit here.
This Sin was a side piece and he lost.
This is self sabotage. I think Vince was trying to inject a lethal dose of poison early on in his career here.
So we are done. WCW is cooking us, man. Damn.
I gotta get out of here.
Oh my god, this is gonna be like the worst.
Well, they're running a free show for free fans on syndicated television. That
would be the worst shit ever. Oh.
Don't worry, it's not over just yet.
Holy fuck, we gotta go out to Times Square. Don't forget about that with Tonk Pedgill.
Yeah, it cuts immediately from Rock winning 3.1. Boo. Anyway, Tonk Pedgill's here in Times Square. Tonk Pedgill is here putting over a cardboard box better than fucking Rocky Maivia.
Oh, my like Dick Clark guy here, he says.
Yeah, he says one of the hottest thing in New York is real estate, so they just make it here. It's the hardest thing ever to get here. He says, have you been inside one of these babies? He's like, it's just cardboard boxes set up for like a homeless guy. He says, you ever been inside one of these? They got a TV, they got jacuzzis. Let me give you a little tour. If your mother-in-law comes in, she stays right here, and he pats it. And then Nikolai Volkoff is in the box and he starts yelling
in
at Todd.
Suit and hat.
Suit and hat, and then they just go back to the arena. What?
So Nikolai Volkoff is homeless?
I don't know. Dude. Anyway, Doug Furness and Philip Amar.
No, anyway, next week, Goldust is pregnant. How did this company not die?
Dude, back at the
would
arena.
Somebody kill this fucking company already?
They showed Doug Furness and Philip LaFon in the ring. The Headbangers music is playing, and Vince on commentary is saying, it's official. Goldust is pregnant.
What the fuck?
They show a magazine, Vanity Fair magazine cover of Goldust pregnant, and they say, next week, Goldust will give birth live
fake,
here on Shotgun
fake
Saturday Night.
Vanity Fair fucking yes. magazine. And Sonny says,
tune in next week.
Fuck you, Rosie O'Donnell, you bitch.
Don't worry about that shitty ass show. Watch our shitty ass show.
What the fuck is going on?
A live birthing next week on Shotgun Saturday Night, exclusively here from the Lenox Hill Hospital.
This has got to
be. What's he got to say?
The worst. Please. I mean, I have watched a lot of shit in my life, but this one takes the cake.
There is genuinely. And I don't even know, like, I'm not trying to exaggerate to be funny. I don't think there's one redeeming part of this show.
Well, Goldust is pregnant.
Goldust is pregnant. It's confirmed. It's official. Oh, all right, shit. Dog.
You know you gotta be popping main event style, so let's get this rocking.
I'm tuning in for that shit. Well, of course, man. Our big main event here, Doug Furness and Philip LaFon against the Headbangers.
Right, they were big ECW guys.
The best part of this, Sonny puts over Doug Furness and Phil LaFon as being 5-time All-Asian, All-Japan tag champions. And she says, Vince, did you know that? And Vince says, well, everybody here is having a good time.
All right. Everyone's having a good time.
Okay. Everyone's having a great time.
Well, I guess the good thing here.
ECW.
I hear that. Dude, the good thing here is that Doug Furness and Phil LaFon beat the fucking shit out of the Headbangers. Fuck you guys, man. Yeah, y'all gotta learn to work right now.
They are working here. There's an ECW chant. Thrasher is yelling at the crowd because he knows that ECW is so sweet at this time, too.
Sucks.
Yeah. Vince is talking about Fondle Me Elmo in commentary. Sonny says Fondle Me Elmo is a handful. Well, she ripped his cock off, so I don't know anymore. Vince says the Headbangers are taking place of the Sister of Loves who were arrested for solicitation on 42nd Street.
Bad idea.
This is fucking crazy.
So Furness takes an Irish whip in his match. Thrasher kicks him in the back. Mosh then... I guess, like, Mosh was like, why are you selling? Why are you selling? So he sells this kick to the back, and Mosh throws a line, and it's fucked up, man. He didn't know he was going to sell. He fucked it all up. Now Phil LaFon's on the apron across the ring yelling, what are you, blind ref?
What are you blind?
There's fucking five of them. Jesus.
Justice Payne. Oh, my God.
Honky Tonk Man! No!
Goldust! I thought Goldust was pregnant! Jesus!
You fucked up! Yeah. Oh. That's how I knew the main event was rocking. When I heard that you fucked up, Chance, I said, finally, man, we're rocking out here.
So we go to commercial, we come back. Todd Pettengill is outside the building. There is a main event match going on.
You can hear the match going on. Yeah.
Yes! The match is going on. You can hear them bumping. Todd Pettengill is outside screaming at some guy. He says, whoa, look at this guy. He's got a Michael Jackson mask on. There's a main event going on.
Todd Pettengill grabbed this fucking guy and pulled him over. He said, look at this guy. He's got a Michael Jackson mask on.
Look at this fucking Michael Jackson motherfucker.
Look at this guy right here.
Dude. He said, anyway, next week we're going to be at the fucking Denim and Diamonds, and they're going to be line dancing and playing pool. Goldust will give birth. Anyway, here's the main event. Anyway, whatever. Who cares? Philip LaFon invents the TNA kick on Mosh and misses it by a mile. Then he hits an awesome senton that crushes Mosh and he dies.
They're kicking the Headbangers' asses.
Dude. Huge float over DDT that looked fucking awesome.
Dude, it was
awesome.
A hip toss reversal DDT. It was crazy.
Oh my God, it was awesome. So sick. Two count on that. Wide shot of them brawling. And Vince says, well, it looks like we're running out of time here, ladies and gentlemen. I said, there's no fucking way. This is impossible. He says, well, looks like we might be running out of time here. We'll show you the ending of this matchup next week when we see you live from San Antonio, Texas. And the fucking show ends. The fucking show ends without showing the fucking finish. I didn't even care about this fucking match. I didn't care about
it's
the fucking principle, man.
Finish of a match.
You fuckers. You fucking Honky Tonk Man. I saw 17 minutes of Honky Tonk Man on this show, and I can't see Philip LaFon and fucking take the fucking stage dive. Just do the stage dive on him and let me fucking
Diesel
see
didn't
it.
Need to go
you bitch.
Diesel didn't need to go 15 minutes. Fake Diesel.
10 minutes of heat, and then he did the jackknife, and I can't see the stage dive on the end of this fucking show. I watched Sonny get her shit blown out by Fuck Me Elmo, and I can't see the fucking finish of this tag match, you bastard! I'm fucking
Honky Tonk Man!
Damn it, dude.
Holy shit. Free wrestling on syndicated television.
You know what's crazy is if Savage was still around, he would have been in the Honky Tonk spot, and it would have been a lot better.
It would have been fun.
Genuinely, Honky Tonk kind of just took that spot over where Savage was hanging out.
He was getting paid, and he didn't care.
Yeah. This is an experience. How the first episode to this episode is insane.
Like, the first episode was, like, car crash. Like, all right, this is cool. Like, all right, I'll watch this. This is fucking stupid. This show is like Vince McMahon shitted out of his ass into his own mouth.
Dude, Vince McMahon couldn't book shit out of his own ass. Are you kidding me, man?
This is crazy,
this is
dude.
Absurd.
What a show. If you have not watched this, you
don't watch it ever.
Don't do that to yourself. And don't do that to yourself. Watch WCW. Please watch WCW. Watch ECW. ECW was about to go on pay-per-view. Fucking Furnace and LaFon were there too.
Right. They're probably kicking fucking shit in. Yeah, so.
Well, there you go. That was Shotgun Saturday Night, the second episode ever, and boy oh boy did it suck dick and balls and
this
ass.
Is like y'all are tripping, man.